Welcome to Game 6 for the now 4-1 Reading Rockets. The Rockets squeezed out an unnecessarily close one last week by knocking off Chelmsford from the ranks of the unbeaten. And we continue our road trip all the way to Leominster this week to face off against North Middlesex, hailing from nearby Townsend, Mass. It's freezing out here. I can't even tell you how happy I am to have A-team cameraman Adam Lee Hooker with us this week, as Brian Van Horn had a previous engagement. I think it might be the first time ever that BVH has had a previous engagement, so good for him, right? I have to say already you're doing a superior job. You know, BVH, a little behind-the-scenes stuff. It's always whining. My thumb's cold. It hurts pressing on and off, you know, that type of thing. But we still look to be without the services of Stephen Webb and also the very tough Sean Beckenhughes, who was part of a minor altercation last week. It led to him having to sit out a game. An altercation, by the way, that could have been avoided if not for the lack of any effort by the referee just to simply separate the boys. It's crazy. But it's going to be interesting to see who's going to pick up that Beckenhughes role. He is a lead blocker on almost every offensive play, and he's a huge, maybe the leading tackler on the team on the other side. So the boys look to continue the winning ways on a chilly Sunday here in Leominster, and kickoff is coming up. Okay, looks like we're ready for kickoff here in North Middlesex. They look like they're dressed up like Boise State out here with the orange and blue. And back deep is going to be Troy Pollock and Dante Barboza. Old-time grass field here. Looks like a little berm right in the middle, too. This will be interesting. The Rockets used to be playing on turf. The ball's going to go out of bounds. It's going to be a penalty, so it's going to be great field position for the Rockets to start here. Nice job by Troy just letting that one go. And the Rockets are going to take over first and 10 from probably the 40-yard line. All right, looks like Lucas Fleming in the backfield with Matt Sagala taking on the role of Beckenhughes for today. It's up a high snap, and Lucas does a nice job getting outside. He's got a big hole there in front of him. He's still in bounds, and Lucas is not going to be caught in the very first play from scrimmage. He takes it all the way, 60 yards for a touchdown. He got outside, and tell you, you see a guy that big, he's the biggest kid on our team. He got outside and he wasn't to be touched. So first play from scrimmage after collecting the high snap, and Lucas pulls it sweep right for a 60-yard touchdown. This could be a long day for North Middlesex, although I tell you, their C team looked excellent. They took out our C team 27-7, but first play from scrimmage, you can notice right away how big the Reading team is versus them, but not only sheer size, but also numbers, right? 34 players for Reading. There's only a couple left here. And Jeremy Ross is going to try the extra point here. Jeremy kicks it. Oh, just a little low. Almost makes it. I tell you, it's a tough one to kick today because it's freezing up here, Adam, isn't it? It's outrageous. I wonder how that feels on your foot. So, hey, after first play from scrimmage, the Rockets send a message early, and it's 6 Reading, 0 North Middlesex. Lucas Fleming ready to kick off here. I'm just telling Adam off camera that Lucas, we mentioned last week, wasn't even going to play football this year after a couple of years of being forced to play with the older and bigger kids. They finally caught up with him, and I think he's glad he made it. He's been a force for this B team this year. Great kick there. Gets met. Ooh, hit low by, looks like, number 22, Danny Damari came in and put a stick on him and dropped some number 42, Derek Van Horn, in there, too. So it looks like North Middlesex is going to take over first and 10 from the 25. That big defensive line for the Rockets in there. First play from scrimmage in the shotgun. It's a keeper right. He gets met immediately and crushed. Wow, that looked like who? 24 was Fleming. I tell you, he runs the first one for a 60-yard touchdown, the very first play for them. He absolutely picks this guy up and slams him to the ground. Welcome.
Kid is all over the place.
Call it second and 11 here. It's another keeper right. Man, he doesn't want to see that guy again. Nice job cutting back. He gets pushed down and tackle right there. Number 15 is Patrick Harrigan coming in. Number, 43, Dante Barboza in there, as well as Patrick DeRoss. So it's going to be third and long upcoming. Okay. Yeah, quick huddles here. I'm tapping Adam to say let's save some battery here, but these guys are getting right into it. Missing one guy waiting for him. It's another keeper right up the middle, and he gets met immediately. Gets crunched. Tell you, number 23, they bring in Alexander Loyal, which is great to see him in there because he's doing some of the job for Beckenhuis. Alexander Loyal. Loyal Alexander. How about that? I got it backwards because they gave me his original thing at the beginning of the year and put it in alphabetical order. Alexander's his last name. So, good guy. That's some top-notch scouting report for me. Loyal Alexander. So number 23 is going to get a lot more time. He's playing the role of Beckenhuis. It's going to be a kick right here. Troy's back. He's going to let it go. Good play right there by Troy. It's going to be just over midfield, and the Rockets are going to take over with excellent field position. Go. All right, here we are. First and 10 again for Rockets just inside their own territory. Once again, it's Fleming and Sagala back. It's a keeper for Fleming this way. He's got a huge hole. He does the same exact thing this time, and he's going to do it again. And he finally gets taken down, gets pushed out after a huge gain. He rips off about 25, and same exact play that scored the touchdown last time. And no secrets of what they're doing with the ball right now, but they see a guy like number 24 coming at him, and he's a tough guy to bring down. So it's going to be first and 10 from the North Middlesex 26-yard line. Here we go, first and 10 here. This time it's Damari in the backfield. He's following Sagala. Danny cuts up. Oh, there's a flag here. I think this one may come back on us here after a nice gain by Danny. Runs it for almost 8 yards, but it looks like they might be bringing it back in a hold, and they are. So it's going to be first and 20 coming up. I'd like to look at that one. It didn't look like a hold to me, Adam, but nonetheless, we're going to move this one back, first and 20. Here we go, first and 20 now for the Rockets after the penalty. It's Sagala and Fleming in the backfield. Direct snap to Lucas. He follows Matt Sagala. Matt Sagala can't even find someone to block in front of him there. And Lucas just takes it outside, and he continues on his feet. They say he stepped out of bounds around the 15-yard line. I wasn't even sure if he did that. But Matt Sagala went through that hole, number 40, and was looking for someone to block. So this could be the start of a long day for North Middlesex here as Reading is moving the ball at will. Here we go. It's first and 10 here from the North Middlesex 15. Not right now. It's Damari in the backfield. Direct snap to Danny. He's going to follow Sagala. Great. Oh, wow. Great pursuit. And Danny cuts back. Wow. He's still on his feet. Oh, he dives down close to inside the 5-yard line. So great pursuit bound defensively. But Danny did a great job to avoid big number 89. And he rips that thing off for very close to a first down. It could very well be, let's call it second and one here. But it's inside the 5-yard line. All right, we got second and call it one here. Sagala and Fleming. Direct snap to Lucas. Oh, he gets met immediately by number 51. Great job by them. Nice job, 51 and 70. Come up and finally meet Lucas head on and stop him, actually push him back a yard or two. So nice to see a good defensive play right here by North Middlesex. And we're looking at third and, let's say, three or four upcoming. Third and 5 coming up here after the pushback on Fleming. You don't see that too often, Adam.
No.
This one's Damari. He's going to follow Sagala, and Danny cuts in. He meets a guy immediately, still stays on his feet, and is he in? He's very close. If he's not in, he has got to have a first down here, I would believe. So let's see if Damari gains the first. I think he does. It's going to be first and goal. Great cutback by Danny. And I say little number 22. There's not a Damari in the world that's actually small. He's huge. And I said, yeah, oh, except of course, Jill. Hey, hold on. Jill Damari's sitting in front of me, and she's sort of small. She's petite. She's lovely. Right? We like that. But we're waiting for Dan to get his inevitable monstrous growth hormone size that all the other Damaris have. It's first and goal here. Call it about a yard. You got Fleming in there. Look for him to keep it. And up, you look like we got some movement here. And this might move the Rockets back 5. So the motion's going to push the Rockets back. It's still first and goal, but now call it from the 7 instead of the 2. You're going to see Lucas Fleming and Sagala back there. Matt Sagala taking on the offensive role of Sean Beckenhuis. Direct snap to Lucas. He cuts right, and he's not going to be stopped. Not even touched in there for his second touchdown early in the game here. So the Rockets moving the ball very effectively offensively here. Lucas goes in for his second touchdown. He might have 12 this year. And great job by the Rockets, and they're going to see if Jeremy can get us two. Jeremy Rosh trying. They switch up Pollock and Harrigan for the hold. Jeremy comes in. He boots it, and oh, it's good. It's the low crossbar. Pops over. So that's 2 points for the Rockets. So nice job there. Hey, while we have time on the break, number seven is Troy Pollock. That is Coach Adam Pollock's son. Little player profile for him. Troy's a Kate Upton fan. Huh? Who isn't, right? His favorite food? Chinese food. That's a first for one of the boys. I like it. You a Chinese food fan?
I do like Chinese food.
All right.
Then again, I eat anything. So.
Well, look at the size of you. The bleachers are tipping up here with me and Adam, Lee Hooker up here. Hey, I've been to China, right?
Oh, yeah.
And the food's not exactly the Mandarin.
No,
I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
It's not exactly yours, right? Hey, little known fact, right? Fortune cookies are actually of Japanese origin.
Really?
Yeah. Made popular in China. And guess what? They don't use them in either one of those countries now. They're only used in America. So I tell you, if you looked at the Japanese or Chinese people, they look at you like three heads if you brought up a fortune cookie. Of course, when I was over in China, they looked at me like I had three heads anyway. Hey, Troy's favorite book, Who Moved My Cheese? You know what that book is?
No.
Yeah, it's one of the all-time great business parables on change management. Talk about a big brain right there for number seven. Hey, we're going to go back to the kick. We'll come back to Troy in a second. Lucas Fleming, it's basically, I think Fleming's had the ball for what? Maybe 80% of our plays here. He kicks, he receives, he kills kids on defense. Look at this kick. It is beautiful. It's going to pin these guys back way deep. He gets picked up and, does he get hit by Damari?
Nice.
What a play. Danny Damari storms down there, looking like Matthew Slater from the Pats putting a lick on somebody, and Damari is going to pin these guys way back.
That was a great kicker.
What a great play, huh? Hey, Troy's superpower he'd like to have? Swim underwater without breathing. What do you think of that?
What would you use that for?
I have no idea. Are you old enough to be to remember the incredible Mr. Limpet?
Oh, yes.
Henry Limpet? Yeah. Maybe he's got a little Henry Limpet.
There you go.
Right. And the one word Troy used to describe himself, intense. No doubt he's intense.
Absolutely.
He is intense. All right, here we go. First play from scrimmage. They are in deep, about the 8-yard line. Not the place you want to be with this huge off. Oh, the ball's in the ground. Let's see if the Rockets get it. I don't know if they did. I think they might have fortunately pounced on that ball. But, man, that big defensive line is just pushing these guys back. We got Patrick DeRoss in there on the right wing this time, covering for Andrew Fortino is actually out, I guess, this week with concussion symptoms. But got Zach Kenyon in the middle there. Dan O'Connor, 54. Dan Junter, and, of course, Fleming over the middle. And he is a monster. That center is going to be seeing stars at the end of this game. So that's a pushback right now. And let's call it second and 13. Handoff gets met immediately from behind the line of scrimmage again. And let's see who's in there. It's hard to see through there, getting up slowly. Number 22, Damari. Is that Damari again? I tell you, Danny is he got himself shaken up there, but Danny is an unbelievable linebacker. That kid sees a hole, and he closes it quickly. He's been doing it all year long. So it's third and long from really terrible position here for North Middlesex, already chasing two touchdowns. All right, it's third and call it 15 here. Number 72, Andrew Hattery back, and he's in for, looks like we're going to call a timeout here for Middlesex. They're going to rethink this one with third and long from inside their five, and we'll come back shortly. Hey, number 70, Dave Lynch, right? I run into Lynchy at the Reading High game last week.
Yeah.
He got a personal foul last week of 15 yards. I asked him about it, right? And he goes, I was just working on finishing my block. If you're sorry, he pushed the guy over, and he literally, like, did an elbow drop like he was off the top rope, huh? So I said, oh, my gosh, we're going to start calling him Superfly, right? He goes, he finished him all right. It was actually great. But how about you? Were you a Georgia boy? Were you a wrestling fan growing up?
Absolutely, man.
Who were the favorites back there?
Oh, you know, it was Hogan, Sting,
yeah, of course.
Road Warrior,
yeah,
those guys.
How about Ric Flair?
Well, nature boy.
Woo! Yeah. He was awesome.
He was North Carolina guy, though. So
oh, okay. Sorry. Jeez, I don't know anything about anything south of Rhode Island. I've never heard of, so it doesn't matter. You have to fill us in there. But Lynchy says his favorite's John Cena. I guess he's a local guy. He's Newburyport, Mass.
Oh, I didn't know.
How about that? Or Newberry, Mass. Sorry. Here we are, third and long here. It's going to be, oh, boy, they don't even get the handoff off. It's a fumble and gets jumped on by Fleming. They didn't even get the handoff before they were on top of their quarterback, and it's going to be fourth and line. Well, not fourth. The Redding got the ball.
Over. Yeah.
And is that on the one-foot line?
Wow.
It could be. We'll come back and find out what it is. All right, here we are, first and goal from the one-foot line on the turnover. We got Sagala and Joe Gilligan, number 32 in the backfield. He was telling us last week he's got running back in his blood. It's a handoff to Joe. He puts his head in, and he's got the touchdown.
Oh,
no, he dropped the ball. Oh, no.
Oh.
They had Gilligan. He's in there, and he ended up fumbling the ball inside there. I thought Joe got in easy. And, wow, talk about turnover than turnover. You know, Coach Junta wanted to get running back in his blood, but that's what Joe had told us. But I'm going to have to talk to his father about that. I'm actually not sure it's in his blood now. I would have said yes if we get that touchdown. But, too bad. He's shaking his head over there. You have Damari get the handoff. But it's going to be now. Wow, now it's first and 10 from inside for North Middlesex. I'll tell you, it wouldn't be shocking to see these guys get put back in the end zone. Not too many plays here. They've been very, very ineffective so far. Uh-oh. It's a keeper right, and he gets pulled down almost immediately. So let's see who's in there on the tackle. Looks like 43 Barbosa is in there. And as always, Lucas Fleming, number 54, Dan O'Connor in there. All right, here we go. It's second, and they actually did get some positive yards here. Second and 9. From the shotgun, number 43 gets outside but gets wrapped up immediately. And is he wrapped up in the end zone or not? It's very hard to see here. I think they're going to say he's down about the half-yard line. Hey, speaking of professional wrestlers, we're up here with Scotty Conroy. He looks like a professional wrestler. Man, he's awesome. He looks like he's unbelievable. He talks like one, too. He's like, hey, come on, brother. He's up here, and I'm just like, I go, guess what, buddy? You're here. We're gonna have to bring up some content in this game. Let's have some fun. I think him and all his brothers could be like a tag team. Be awesome. These guys are. All right, it's third down here, called 11, and it is very close to the goal line. Very difficult to move the ball here. And it's a call. He's going to pass here, and he gets tipped in the middle.
Oh.
Oh, boy. We had Oki. We had Zach Kenyon going up for a deflected, maybe interception. They could have been heroes there. We'll have to look at that closely. Maybe they ran into each other, but they try a pass, and it gets tipped. It might have been Fleming in there and almost came down with it. It's going to be fourth down, and they're going to have to kick here, or at least, I don't know, kicking's tough with this wind. This wind's going right in their face at them, and it's, you got to imagine there's not going to be a whole lot of net gain yardage here, so we'll see what they're going to do on fourth. All right, fourth down here. Looks like this is the end of the quarter, so that's fortunate for them because they may kick. Now the wind's with them. Oh, boy. And it's a safety because he actually went down to his knee to field that ball. The ball skipped. And Redding's going to tack two more on here and get the ball back. So, unfortunate snap. He tried to go down and pick up that snap and kick away. He was on his knee, and it's an automatic down there. So, it's a safety for North Middlesex. And at the start of the second quarter, it's Redding 16, North Middlesex 0. All right, hey, it looks like they got to do a free kick from the 20. And back deep, number 23, Loyal Alexander. The whole team is cheering him on back there. So credit Bob Junta and the coaching staff here. Up 16-0, and looks like a team that Redding obviously is handling here, getting some other guys in hand. Loyal's a really good athlete, actually. We got a nice gigantic telephone pole in front of us from this angle, too. Great kick there. It's going to go to Loyal. Fields it. Here's Loyal right now. He runs left. He's got some great block ahead of him by Harrigan. Harrigan goes and grabs another one. So beautiful run back by Loyal. Look at the team. Absolutely fired up for the teammate. Beautiful catch by Loyal. He runs it back inside the 30. And credit number 15, Patrick Harrigan, for not one but two blocks to help him out. I think they're all extra fired up to help out their buddy Loyal. So nice job for Redding and a beautiful run back. And it's nice to feel the sun out here, buddy. The sun has just brought us up about 3 degrees. So I'm thrilled. We'll come back in a sec. Here we go. It's first and 10 here after the nice run back by Loyal. Patrick Harrigan under center. Back deep is Fleming. Hand off to Lucas. Big hole. Runs right through the first tackle. He's got nothing but room ahead of him. Just charging for the sideline. Cuts back in and gets tripped up inside the 10, maybe the 5. So Lucas has run for about 100 yards here in the first quarter plus. And guess what? It's snowing now. It's sunny out and it's snowing. Are we getting this?
Yeah.
This is the crazy. Where are we? Well, we're in Mars right now. It's in Maine. It's snowing. It's sunny. It's freezing. So how about that? You don't see the snow out while it's sunny that often,
no,
do you? Have you ever seen that in Georgia?
Not a chance. 2 inches max.
This is called snow, Adam, right? And normally we don't see it when it's sunny out either. So here we go. It's going to be first and 10 here. Harrigan under center. Joe Gilligan back deep this time. Let's see if he'll give the ball back to Joe. They give it to Joe. He hands up the middle. He gets met almost immediately after a short gain. So they got Joe in the backfield. This time does a nice job holding on to it. And we're going to look at second and goal coming up. Here we go. It's going to be second and goal here. Talking with Adam off camera. He's from Georgia. Never mind does he deal with 45 degrees ever. It's also snowing.
Not used to this.
Last week was 85. Joe Gilligan up the middle. Joey cuts back and he's in.
There he is.
Yes! Second time around is a charm for Gilligan, and maybe he does have running back in his blood after all. So nice cutback for Joe, and he gets on board here. Beautiful play right there, so credit the team for that. Joe lost his first effort on the goal line, but hey, listen, sometimes you just got to go back to the money, and he was money this time. Number 32, Joe Gilligan. It's actually a blizzard right now. It's a blizzard. Wow, this is fun though, isn't it? You never see anything like it.
Oh, no.
All right, we'll come back in a sec. All right, we're going to do the extra point here. Look for the Rockets to go for one here. Gilligan in the backfield again. Looks like Jeremy Rosh as well. Harrigan on the center. It's a handoff to Gilligan up the middle. He puts his head down, and he's very close, but I don't think he gets in, and he doesn't get in. So with we don't know what the clock. They're not keeping the clock, but the Rockets are up 22-0 here early, and look for Coach Junta to get some other guys involved. Hey, number 15 is Patrick Harrigan. He's a big fan of Jamal Charles and Alex Morgan. How about Charles? He might be out for the A's, right? His favorite food, get this, salmon.
Really?
Huh? Pretty highfalutin for a little 12-year-old kid, right? Get a load of this. We'll come back in a second as Lucas gets ready to kick off here. And now it is absolutely a blizzard out here. It's something. Nice touchdown by Joe Gilligan. Here's the kickoff by Lucas. It's a good one. Number 51 back deep, and scoops it up, and he starts running, and immediately, nice block there on Damari. He was in quick, and who else is it? Let's see, number 43 was Dante Barbosa to bring him down. Hey, getting back to Patrick, number 15, little known fact about salmon. They can travel up to 3,500 miles to spawn.
Wow.
How about that? You only came up from Georgia.
Right, 1,700
miles. Listen, you got
miles,
nothing on salmon, right? let me see this. Salmon actually have better senses of smell than dogs or bears.
Really?
Yeah. You know who else has a better sense of smell than a salmon?
What's that?
Coach Bob Junta. Yeah. I've been on Damari quite a bit this year. Yeah, so I might as well hop on Junta. But and the animal, we'll come back in a sec to Patrick. Number 15, we'll come back. It's first and 10 here. Good field position, or at least the best field position they've had. It's a keeper left. He's got a nice little hole, number 51. He's got some room. Beautiful seam right there. There's one guy left. Oh, he's still on his feet. He gets past. Wow, and he's going to go the distance here. Beautiful hole opened up for number 51, and he rips it off for about, let's say, 65 yards there. So great play for North Middlesex. Huge seam, and he takes it all the way to the house. So North Middlesex gets on the board here in the second quarter. After a huge play from scrimmage, their first maybe positive gain from scrimmage all day. We'll come back for the extra. Here we go for the extra point. It looks like, let's see if they're setting up. They're setting up for one here. in the shotgun, number 99. Keeps it. He's a big boy, and he runs right in.
Wow.
So, wow, big hole there. And at the very end of that last play, Keegan Lee almost had a bead on him, and he just got around him and ran past him for the touchdown. And they go in for a big hole here. So let's call it 22-7 right now. Only 1 point for the carry. It says 22-8 on the scoreboard here. But nonetheless, the Rockets will get the ball back. Hey, let's go back to this is amazing, right? I'm looking at a couple of notes here on Patrick, and the snow has actually smudged my never thought the snow would smudge my paper here. But getting back to the animal that number 15 Patrick Harrigan wants to be, hippopotamus.
You just imagine? The way around in the mud?
Yeah, you know what? Maybe hey, you must know a lot about it. The hippopotamuses, they hang out in Atlanta, don't they? Yeah, no, just a little note here. The plural of hippopotamus is not hippopotami. No, it's not. No, they said this online on a kid's thing, right? Hippopotamus has short legs, huge mouth, and a body shaped like a barrel. Yeah, sounds like the coaching staff of the Rockets, don't they? Listen, Jill Damari is agreeing with me right here. Although right now, you know Adam Pollock and Danny Webb are saying, I know they're not talking about us, you know? So let's see. What do we got here? I will say this. I have woefully left Coach Dan Webb out of my sights this year, and don't worry, it's coming. So no one gets a free pass up here with us, Adam, here in the beat squad. But it looks like big number 99 ready to kick off here. Back deep is going to be, looks like Loyal again and Dante Barboza. Nice kick, and it's going to go over to Loyal. Loyal's going to pick it up. All right, here's Loyal's chance here. Got a little bit of room. There's Harrigan again. Oh, there's a face mask, and they do call it. He's still on his feet and gets ripped down, but it came right across Loyal's face, and that's going to tag on another 15 at least, a face mask on Loyal, and that's going to put the Rockets with first and 10 with excellent field position coming up. I never thought I'd have to say this in October, Adam, but let's keep the snow off the camera. All right, looks like maybe Harrigan under center here. It is a handoff up the middle to number 22, Damari, and Danny drives it forward for probably at least four, maybe five over midfield. Okay, not a great spot there for Dan, but he's right at the 50-yard line. We'll call it second and six. Damari back deep again. Sagala getting a ton of playing time here on both sides. Hand off to Danny. Danny's got room. Oh, he absolutely crunches two guys, runs them over, and he drives that very close to the first down. I'll tell you, like I said, he's one of the better running backs there. And took a big lick there. He's got a little bit of grass he's got to pull out. Maybe he'll take a breather on this one. So it looks like it is a first down coming up. All right, here we go. They're going to have Lucas Fleming come in for Damari right now. Under center is Harrigan. It's a handoff to Lucas. He puts his head down, drives it for an easy six or seven up the middle, and they haven't had an answer for the big man at all this game, and it's going to be second and short upcoming. Call it second and a long three here. Stevie Needham leads the team out. Our center goes to Harrigan. It's a handoff to Lucas again. They're calling 24. The ball's on the ground, and it looks like North Middlesex has it. So Lucas gets stripped of the ball and turns it over. And that's been, if they can say one thing that's been an issue with Lucas this year, it's had a little bit of trouble holding the ball. But I'm going to say it's a very, very tough one here today. It is freezing out here in tough conditions. And Lucas has got the bare arms out there and tough to hold on to the ball. And they do turn over the ball. So, hey, credit North Middlesex here. And with the 22-7 game in the second quarter, we saw what they did on the last set of downs. And maybe they can make this thing a game after all. Coach imploring Derek Van Horn to get out there at safety. It's a keeper left. He gets hopped on by Dante Barboza. Pushed back and pushed way back. So Barboza comes in. He tackles him up high. He doesn't take him back, but he spins him back for five. It's going to be a loss. Call it second and maybe 12 or maybe more than that upcoming. North Middlesex coach imploring his boys, the Cowboys. Is that what Boise State is? Are they the Cowboys too?
Broncos.
There you go. Yeah. Well, these guys are the Cowboys. He's telling them, come on, Cowboys. There's going to be a pass. He rolls out here. Oh, boy. gets ripped down by Damari. He's going to say he's down, but Danny Damari catches him before he can get the pass off. Unfortunately, he's going right through this gigantic light stanchion in front of us. But great play by Damari, putting some heat on him, and he might have been better off just throwing that one away. So it's going to be third and forever coming up here from their 22. They got a, let's call it 25 yards. This is a big play here. We got good news. We got the pole right here. Maybe I'll ask Joe Gilligan to come move that pole for us. He's right down to the left of us. Look for a pass here. It almost has to be. Looked like movement. It's going to be a keeper. Oh, it's actually an inside handoff there, so they tricked us. You know what happened? I got caught looking behind the pole. So the pole stopped me, too. And it's going to be fourth down here. And see the boys holding their hands there. It is cold, man, if they don't have any gloves on. So it's going to be fourth and forever here. And look for the Cowboys of North Middlesex to punt here. Here we are, fourth down, and it is going to be a punting situation. Back deep, we have Dante Barbosa. It's a low snap. Does a good job to actually pick it up, and it's a good kick. Goes right to Dante at the 44. Dante, a little straight arm. He's got wheels, man. Oh, he cuts back, and he rips that for about 20 yards. So beautiful run back by Dante. It's going to be excellent field position for the Rockets coming up, and you hear Coach Junta calling red offense. So first and 10 from, let's say, the 30, inside the 35-yard line. Hey, we had a 10 to a North Middlesex player who's hurt over there. I tell you, every hit stings a little bit more in the cold weather, doesn't it? It's going to be a pitch out here to Damari. He's got room outside. Danny tries to beat him. Great tackle by number 18 to catch up with him. But Danny takes that for a nice gain. It's sort of hard to see the field numbers from this vantage point, but he looks like he gains about 5 or 6. Okay, it's 2-minute warning right there, and Danny does get 6. So call it second and, say, a long 4. Harrigan under center, Damari back deep. It's going to be a pitch out to Damari. He cuts back up. He sees a hole. Gets met almost immediately, so Danny does get a couple of yards there. It's going to be 3rd and maybe 3 upcoming. There's a flag on the ground, but I don't know if it was thrown or if it fell out. I didn't see anything there, but the Rockets may be moving back here. Yeah.
Looks like they got a hold and go.
I think you're right about that. We'll check back in. The holding call does push them back, so it's going to be 2nd and 15 here, just under 15. Same lineup, Sagala and Damari behind Harrigan. It's inside handoff there to Dante. He's got wheels. Oh, he runs right over number 12. He's still on his feet, and he's still on his feet. Oh, the straight arm. Wow, what a run. And there's a flag down there, and I don't know if that might be called on Dante against them because he might have got his hand wrapped around a face mask on them. It was a beautiful run by Dante. Hopefully that happens at the end of the run. And tell you, he absolutely steamrolled one of their players, kept running, couldn't get knocked on his feet. He tries to straight arm him, and they call it a face mask on Dante, of all people. So they may be bringing this whole thing back. I didn't know if that would be something that would happen at the end of the run, and I think it is. So big 15-yard penalty, though, and I don't fault Dante at all on that one. We'll have to look at that play. Beautiful, beautiful run.
Great effort, yeah.
Great effort. So I tell you, he's got some wheels, number 43, doesn't he?
Yep.
This is his first year playing football, so.
Oh, that's
how about that? So here we go. It's going to be 2nd down and call it they say 2nd, call it 10. Harrigan with Sagala, fullback. Damari back deep. It's a pitch out to Damari. Beautiful pitch and beautiful hole for Danny. He runs through it. So we talked about that, and Patrick did a beautiful job leading him there. You know, so turning around and hitting him right in stride, he rips that off. That's a first down. All right, it's going to be 1st and 10 here. We get some color commentary up here. Oh, inside back to Dante. He gets wrapped up immediately, though. So nice defensive play. Didn't really trick these guys. I said, these are the ones where sometimes the reverses, you tend to overthink it.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If these guys, if you can't stop them on the sweeps, then the reverses, you're running right into players. So in that sense, trying some different plays here, maybe some different looks, and this might be the time of year that you can try some things that you've been working on that we haven't put in yet. And it's going to be second and, let's call it, nine. All right, we're hearing him call 42 seconds left in the half with one timeout. Harrigan under center. Damari's back deep, take my word for it. He is behind that. It's a pitch out to Damari. Danny cuts it up. He's got room on the outside. He's going to be tough to catch. Danny finally dives for it in the goal, and does he get in? He does. Danny gets the touchdown on the far side there. I don't know if you can see it with that.
No, we missed it on the camera.
Oh, man. I told you, of all the places, but Danny does get outside and dives in at right before the half here for the goal. So beautiful run for Damari. And it looks like we're sending Loyal Alexander in there for the extra point, number 23. So look for 23 to grab it. Are they well in the week? All right, here we are. It's the extra point here. I hear Coach Mike Masucci hands it off to Loyal. Loyal gets met almost immediately. I think I heard Mike Masucci yelling at him, go get some cold cuts. I don't know exactly what that means, but maybe what was that, the Icky Woods one? I'm getting some cold cuts. Remember that one? Yeah. I don't know if he's referring to that, because clearly Mike watches way too much TV. So let's see. Right before the half here it is, Reading 28, North Middlesex 7. Fleming ready to kick off here after the Damari touchdown. The Rockets really having their way today here in Leominster. Beautiful kick by Lucas, fielded nicely. Number 51 cuts aside and he gets wrapped up immediately. And what number are we calling again? Number 22, Danny Damari. So Danny has been outstanding on special teams today. He's a phenomenal linebacker closing up, and he's a great running back. So great job, big game by Damari. You know, one thing I wanted to mention about Troy Pollock last week, too, as I did a player profile, what a game he had. He played a game last week in Chelmsford that was unbelievable, and with his thumb all wrapped up, his left thumb. The kid's tough as nails. He is intense, right?
Yes,
that was the one
absolutely.
He wanted. So here it is, first and 10 here for the Cowboys of North Middlesex chasing three touchdowns from their own 35. And could be the last play before the half here, so look for these guys to try to throw it. Oh, it looks like some movement already, or it looked like they threw it immediately. Maybe somebody was offsides. I think it might have been the Rockets lined up in the neutral zone, and it is. So they're going to replay that one, and they can't end on a defensive penalty, so it looks like there to be another play left. All right, here we are. It's going to be first and 5 now. Can only be a few ticks left on the clock here. We got Keegan Lee back deep, number 20. Maybe a passing situation here. And it is. He tries to throw it up. He heaves it up. Oh, he actually makes the catch. And number 80, Tully was there. Tully came in to try to swat, and they went in there. It's a first down, so heaved up a little bit of a duck, but they pulled it down. But that's going to be the half here. So at halftime, this has been a game that the Rockets have basically had in hand since the very first play from scrimmage. And this might be a time in the second half for Coach to get a number of players in there and see what he's got for depth. But going into the second half here, it is Reading 28, North Middlesex 7. Okay, listen, we're actually going to get ready for the kick here, but we're going to come back to Coach Adam Pollock. We do a little segment, Adam, where we have the coaches answer the kids' surveys. And when the coaches don't send me one, we just make up stories about them. So we're going to get on Coach Adam Pollock here soon enough. Looks like our Zoom isn't working right now, so we're going to try that manually. Here we go. It's the kick by Lucas, and it's a good one. Number 51 gets in there. Patrick Harrigan in close. There's Damari again. He gets past Damari this time, but gets wrapped up by Barboza high. Looks like, oh, the ball's on the ground. He gets picked up by Barboza. Oh, boy, I couldn't see behind this huge thing. He gets knocked over. Barboza takes him down, strips the ball, picks it up, and runs it in for a touchdown. They're going to see if that's actually what the call is, but I think that's what it is. Wow. What a play right there, the very first play. Barboza goes high, and number 21, Keith Richmond, went low, and the ball springs out. I couldn't see behind the massive light stanchion again here. I tell you, there's only one here. There's been more great plays behind this thing today, right? It's like me standing behind you up here, Adam. Jeez Louise. So it's going to be a touchdown for Barboza. Great athletic play there. And it's gonna they're going to be going for one. Huh? Hey, who's better than me doing a little technical, you know? I was in the AV club in school. No, I actually wasn't, huh? No, but good thing Josh Blumenschein was here because he was one of the top guys at AV at his high school, I heard, out in Illinois. So it looks like they missed that one. I don't know if they just went to a knee on that particular one, but Barboza comes up with a touchdown. And I don't know what the rules are here when you're up this much. I do believe we have to just run off tackle. If you're up a ton here, you'll see that Pop Warner rules will say you run off tackle. But I will say this, is that this is the time you're going to see Coach Junta get a lot of players in here and have a lot of fun at the end here. Give some boys a chance to run the ball. And here we go. There is Coach Mike Masucci, who did confirm with me at the halftime that he was imploring Loyal Alexander to go get the cold cuts.
Wow.
So, yeah. All right, here we go. It looks like now Lucas is going to kick off again. It's Groundhog Day here again. He's kicked off about 9 times here today. He's just hoping to get in and get his jacket on with his short sleeves. Lucas boots the ball. That's a live ball right there, picked up by number 42. He puts his head down, gets met immediately by, it looked like, Damari again. Call his name again, Danny, right? Danny, yep, makes the tackle again. He's made a ton of tackles, had a great touchdown. He's made just plays all over the field today. So it looks like it's going to be first and 10 here, and the wind is, the sun goes behind the clouds and it drops 15 degrees. Isn't it great?
Yeah.
I'm looking at Blumenschein and Adam Lee Hooker here, about 600 pounds of fun here, just wishing they could hold each other, shivering. It's unbelievable. Now the wind's kicking up. Yeah, that's exactly. Hey, and the snow's back. The snow's back, guys. From the shotgun here. They got 3 guys stacked left. He's going to follow those guys. Number 99. He's got some room outside. Oh, there's a flag right there. Looks like number Damari, or 82, Patrick Duras, got mauled over there by number 51. And that's going to pull this thing back. Duras had a beat on him. He got tackled. So that's going to move the nice run from the scrimmage back. And now we're fighting the snow right in our face. Cool. I never thought I'd have to say this, but, you know, make sure we keep the snow out of the camera bag.
Switching.
Go. Now it's first and 20 here after that, and the blizzard is kicking up again. Kicked one left there. Same play there. He's got a big play. Gets hit by a couple of guys in there. Lynchy, number 70, pulls a superfly on him over there. Let's see who else is in there. 71 was in there. Pat Dwyer and 42, Derek Van Horn. So we're sitting here. Jill Damari's right in front of us. She's wrapped in a red blanket. And she looks very much like Mrs. Claus here right now. You know? So we're all wrapped up here like it's the middle of the winter, freezing, because we certainly didn't prepare for it. But it's going to be second and call it 9 here after a nice gain. Dave Swanson running off. Too many guys on the field there. It's a keeper right here. Nice run for the first down. Ooh, big hit right over, I think. Let's see who that was. Nice hit over. I think it was Pat Dwyer who was in there. 71, Pat Dwyer, I believe. And Dwyer gets crunched, but he does take him down, so sacrifices him there. And I think number 32, Joe Gilligan's over there too. So Pat took a big lick there, but he did make the tackle. All right, this is getting really crazy now, isn't it? We might have to wipe off the screen here. We are in a whiteout blizzard. I don't know about you, it's sort of fun. It's going to be more fun when I get in my car. You guys stay out here for another 2 hours. Oh, boy, looks like there's motion. Wow, big stiff arm over there on number 14 was Jonathan Grady, but this thing's going to come back, I believe. Wow, it's crazy up here, but it's fun, I think. I think it's fun.
For the kids, maybe.
All right, well, good news is we just got that comment on camera, so. All right, Mrs. Claus Damari is out of here. Mrs. Claus is out of here. She's got to go feed the reindeer. They're running for their lives right now. But here it is, first down. I guess it was. I don't know if that was actually against, so they waved it off. keep the drive running here. Number 51 keeps it left. Right there, Pat, oh, just gets around Dwyer. Pat had a nice job. It's a nice run there. And these guys get stacked up after a big gain. So Coach Junta getting a lot of different plays in here on D right now. But North Middlesex moving the ball well on this drive. All right, here we go. It's first and 10 here from just outside, let's see, the 10-yard line. Guest color commentary here. Josh Blumenschein, the A play-by-play player. Oh, number 99 goes outside, and Dwyer can't catch him, and he gets in. So they get in. Nice series of downs here for North Middlesex late in the game here. I think we're still in the third quarter. But it's been a crazy one out here, and Josh Blumenschein is in the house. How you doing?
Hey, football as it's meant to be played in the snow.
You love it, right? This is how it was in Illinois where you grew up, right?
Actually, yeah, more games in the snow than not.
Yeah, how about that? So it looks like North Middlesex is going to go for one. I don't think they have a kick in their arsenal. We haven't seen it yet anyway, but we'll see what happens here. A lot of new guys in that line in there. Adam Diemer in there, 64. Watch him. He's tough. It's a keeper for his 55. He gets outside, gets spun around immediately by 53. Stevie Needham right in there, but he couldn't hold on him, and he rushes in there. So tack on another one, and late in the third quarter, it's Reading 34, North Middlesex 13.
You know what that means, Oak?
What's that mean?
Reading can score another touchdown.
All right. I like to see it. I love to see look at this. He's talking right now to number 14, Jonathan Grady. Look for Jonathan to pick up this ball here. This is what I like about Coach. We're going to get some other guys involved. Let's go right here on this guy right here. We're going to get back to Coach Adam Pollock. I was mentioning, Josh, we had the coaches answer the kids' surveys.
All right.
And some of them didn't return them. So we just made up stuff. And so Adam Pollock is actually a big fan of Kool and the Gang.
Yeah.
And he says he likes saying the word effervescent repeatedly while looking at himself in the mirror.
Both those things I can believe.
Yeah, yeah. Do you know what some phonoaesthetic experts would say is the most beautiful sounding word in the English language?
What's that?
Elbow. Can you believe that?
No.
That's a true story. It's elbow. Coach Pollock enjoys his time with his dog, Gus, and that's it. That's the only thing he enjoys. Right? So the other thing is he claims to have invented the apostrophe.
All right.
Yeah, I don't know. But being O'Connor, I guess I got to be happy about that. So thanks, Coach Pollock. Oh, look at this one. You say get away from the ball. It has to go 10 yards. And it does not go. How about
those
that?
Well-coached Reading Rockets, huh?
Yeah.
Stay away from it.
That's right. Either they were well-coached or the whole team was not paying attention. Like we were as we're razzing on Coach Pollock here. Good job there. It has to go 10 yards in order for them to take the ball there. So nice sort of little bit of trickery there. It just didn't go far enough, and the Rockets are going to take over.
They remind me of another Western team, the Boise State.
Yeah, we
talked
about that.
They get the same sort of colors, the little trick play off the kick. Didn't work out.
You know what would be great? If we had a giant blue field.
That would be excellent.
I'm going to tell you a true story about watching Boise State for the first time years ago. I thought my TV was so screwed up that I changed it. I changed all the tint settings to make the field green, and it messed up my TV for a month. I'm not kidding you. I'm like, who does that?
Oh my!
It was years ago. I totally messed up my TV. Let's see who we have here in the backfield.
I think Harrigan under center still.
It is. Inside hand up to Jeremy Rosh. And Jeremy Rosh has got all sorts of daylight in front of him. Great play by number. Ooh, pulls him down by the face mask. But he was already out of bounds, I think. So great run by Jeremy.
He's up around the shoulders.
Yeah, so it looks like Jeremy takes that, if not very close. He has the first down. But there's a flag on the field, too. I don't know if they're going to walk it off. So I don't know if they call a hold here. And they do.
Always disappointing to see one of those first downs get called back.
Yeah, I think this is the first time Jeremy had his hands on the ball offensively. But I'll tell you, he's been a huge player for this team on both sides of the ball. He is a talented athlete. It's going to be first and 10 here. First and 20 from the Rockets' 41-yard line. Harrigan with Fleming back deep. It's a handoff to Fleming. Wow, what a hole. It is huge, and he may go.
What a powerful runner.
He is moving. I don't think he's going to be caught. Just running. Oh, he is get caught. Beautiful play by 51 to take him down.
Hey, shades of Leonard Fournette on that run.
Oh, my God.
He's the size, the speed.
He's exactly the same size as Leonard Fournette right now, and he's 12. Yeah, it's unbelievable, huh? How about that guy Fournette? He can play, huh?
Yeah.
We were talking off screen about that Michigan State game yesterday. Was that something? A fumble to win the game in Michigan. Can you imagine being in the Big House? There was 110,000 people there walking away crying.
That Spartan that recovered the ball had to take it to the house. Time ran out on the 1 yard line.
Yeah, how about that? That's what a play. Let's see if we can see something similar here.
Trevor Conroy out wide left.
Oh, boy. Wow, he bats immediately and doesn't go down. Finally, they come in and hit him. So nice job for the initial hit. Hit very hard and still doesn't knock him over. But then the defense comes in and wraps him up. So
number
pushes him back a little.
Cleaned it up.
This is going to be second and call it 14 coming up. All right, here we go. Call it second and, let's see, 13 on the pushback. It's going to be another pitch to Lucas Fleming, and I'll tell you, nice cutback there. That's a guy who looked like he didn't want to go hit him, right? But Lucas gets hit at the very end.
I think
good
he made
hit.
It.
And he's in.
He's in.
That might be number three for Lucas today.
Wow.
Wow. And then, hey, we have missed more unbelievable plays in that back corner. Josh, get ready for the A game, because if anything goes back there, you're going to have to take our word for it. Hey, you know what?
We need to be going left to right.
You know what I'm going to do right now, because no one really saw it? I'm going to say Danny O'Connor scored that. number 54 he put in there, ran for 34 hard yards. Nice job by Oki. He's the best. Hey, anytime we get to pump the tires of our own kids, we're going to do it.
That's right. We talked about that.
I hope the A team does that as well. Because when you're volunteering, it's 35 degrees, sunny, and snowing on you. We gotta do something, right? All right, here's the extra point try here. Let's see if number 23, Loyal Alexander.
Is B team, we throw it very often? It doesn't seem so.
No, well, listen, you don't have to. You don't have to when you're successful running the ball. There's Loyal going on the outside, and Loyal's going to get in. Yeah.
Hey, watch the block by number 80 there. I wish we could show that again. Trevor Conroy. He took his man out, allowing Alexander to get to the outside there.
You know, we made a couple of comments on Trevor, how he it's the term's overused now, but you want to talk about setting an edge?
Yeah.
No one gets around him, and Trevor has made some huge blocks this year that way. And we got to be getting close to the fourth quarter here. The sun's out, so it's gone up a degree and a half here, which is nice. But right now it's 41 Reading, 14 North Middlesex. Okay, Lucas Fleming back to kick. We get the boys from the A squad coming in here. By all accounts, the A squad team is supposed to be a good team from North Middlesex, 4-1. The B team's had their way here today, but the other teams actually haven't fared so well. E team, oh boy, wow, big run bite there. Took us a big hit, and he's still on his feet. So
the ball was moving around there. Reading was intending to tackle the ball. A nose for the ball there.
Here we go. It's going to be first and 10 here for North Middlesex from right around midfield. Here we go, first and 10 here. Hasn't been a whole lot of success on the North Middlesex side today. Couple of big plays, one nice series drive, the last one. Number 55 is going to keep the ball. He gets wrapped up immediately by 51. Kenyon was in there. Let's see who else jumps in there. Number 71, Pat Dwyer. We called Pat Dwyer's name a couple times. He's getting fired up out here. I think his dad told him there was some Kobe beef burgers after the game. I just want to get inside my car and turn on the heat. Wow, Adam commenting that might have been the longest third quarter of the year. Of course, it makes it a little bit longer when you can't feel your feet, your toes, or your face. But this is going to be, let's see, a second down here and about seven. I think the North Middlesex guys are actually giving their own guys a chance to run the ball here too.
Cowboys with an interesting backfield formation I haven't seen before.
Uh-oh, we got some movement too. Hey, you just noticed the interesting formation. Someone moves, is going to move them back. So we're going to be second and 10 upcoming. Here we go. It's going to be second and call it 11 after the pushback. Same formation here.
Sweep to the right. Saw that coming. 55.
Nice run by number 55, and he gets hit at the very end by number 50.
Adam
right
Nola.
There is Adam Nola. So nice job by Nola. He takes a good hit there, but 55 is a big little guy. He had a big hole to fall through there. You know, we talked about not the need for a lot of passing on the Rocket side. I don't even think they've thrown one today. Same thing on the other side. I don't think they have too many passes in their arsenal, and it's a time when they may have needed some. A few times they did have to pass, it looked like they haven't quite practiced those. But they are a pretty big team, but they're not a deep team. There's only three or four subs out there, so these kids have been on the field the entire day, and Redding just rolls wave after wave after you. Big number 99 there. He gets stacked up early, pushes him down. Let's see who's in on that one. Number 10, Mason Dion in there. See number 64, Adam Deemer as well.
That's a big boy for B Division.
He sure is.
Number 99.
Yeah, he sure is, yeah. I think the weight limit and Fleming was very close to is 155. Fleming's running very close to
for
150.
B's. Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's some guys here clearly well under that. To keep a right. Oh, number 53 was Needham in there. He gets over pursued, and he's got a big run here. He's got three or four guys on here. They need to still have
still
he's
on
still
his
on
feet.
His feet. Wow. So the Rockets here, they're bringing in some guys here. They got to work on the gang tackling here. But nice run for number 51 there, and he takes it for maybe 20 and more, gets down close to the red zone.
Question for you, Oka. Are there many Cowboys out here in Leominster?
Listen, I might as well be in Nebraska right now. That's
yeah,
the way that it feels.
We're so far west.
It took that long. I thought I took a flight in here on a biplane. Yeah, we are out there. There might be some Cowboys on the other side. I see a lot of pickup trucks over on the other side, I'll tell you that. Here we go, big number 99 in the shotgun. Look for him to follow those three blockers.
To the right.
That's what he does. Oh, he goes right up the middle this time. Whoa.
Wow.
He pushes him back, but that's number 51 is Zach Kenyon. And that's a big guy to run into him. Credit Kenyon for staying with him and taking him down,
taking
huh?
Down. Absolutely.
Dad's up here. He's looking at him going, oh, hey, it's a good tackle. But you'd like to not pull a guy like that on top of you. He'll feel that one later in the day. Hey, let me guess. There's going to be a really great play here in the far corner behind this gigantic pole. We missed three of them. And the shotgun, number 55, he's going to go
left
this time. He gets met immediately.
Good gap control on the defensive line.
Bunch of Rockets in there. Mason Dion, let's see, Stevie Needham in there. And Zach Kenyon in there again, just pulling people on top of himself again. Hey, you got to get him down is the way
whatever
to do
works.
It. Whatever works, right? I have Josh Blumenschein give me a little grief on the clipboard I have here. Let's see what it looks like. Open it up. Tell me. Why don't you describe it for us, Josh?
Well, we've got pink and we've got some white polka dots going on here, and it's got a nice little design.
Well, you
got
to open it up. There's really something nice under there.
Cute little owl.
Yeah, it's an owl. I stole it from my daughter Grace's bureau this morning because I couldn't find a clipboard. So, and we've won every game that I've had the orange pink polka dotted clipboard.
Big hole out to the right.
51 gets
He's
in there.
He's able to get it down to the goal line, just short.
Let's see who was in there on the tackle.
He had all sorts of room to run on that right edge.
I'm looking at number 80 over there with the tackle. It's Cole Tully. So Tully with the tackle, but they're very close. It looks like it's going to be first and goal from inside the two-yard line. But, yeah, we've won every game with the pink polka-dotted orange owl clipboard. So
that must be the reason.
I think so. Or North Middlesex, and we don't know what the time is here, but I just hope it's quick. I can't wait to ditch you guys and go home.
The initial drive of the fourth quarter.
Here we go. Number 51 in the shotgun. Oh, it's a quick snap. They went right up the middle. It looks like a little trickery there.
A little bush.
And they get in. They get in. Yeah. So here's some cheering from the Cowboys side over there. Get a touchdown. Getting some different players in there as well, give them to handle the ball. So they go in now to make it 41-20, and we'll see the extra point upcoming. Extra point try here for the Cowboys. Oh, it's going to be a – oh, it looked like he was thinking about passing it. Oh, he gets met immediately by number 12. I think that was –
42, Derek Van Horn
had
Derek the initial
Van Horn
on
had him.
Spun him around.
Couldn't pull him down, though.
Strung the play out, and the conversion was unsuccessful.
Hey, speaking of that, I wanted to say earlier we got Adam Lee Hooker here to cover for Brian Van Horn.
Oh.
And I'll tell you right now, I've you know, I didn't realize how poorly a job Brian Van Horn did until I saw Adam Lee run this camera. Wow, I thought, you know what? You don't miss what you never had, and I come in here, and this guy, you should be working for CBS. All right, well, they don't get in. Nice pushback right there, but Derek was the star, couldn't pull him down, but then he got some extra help, and they do stop him, and it's 41-20 here late. It's going to be a kickoff here, and the wind is really whipping up in the, right in the face of the North Middlesex Cowboys here. They're going to look for the onside kick. They got six guys across the front. Now they're going to spread them out.
The hands team.
Bring that team, and it looks like they are going to kick away now. They thought they were going to try another onside kick, and they may try it anyway. You know, they may try to have a move one way. And it looks like that's what they're going to do. So they try the onside kick there. Goes up and over. Nice job, Jeremy. Oh, boy, the ball is loose. Wow, Jeremy Ross,
you know,
had his hands on it.
He had it initially.
Number 51.
Cowboy came in and knocked it away.
Zach Kenyon grabs it right here. I was about to go pat his father on the shoulder here, and he just ran for cover, I think. He was whimpering like a small child up here,
I was just wondering what you were going to pat him on.
I tell you, I'm looking at Mary DeRoss ahead of me right here. She's dressed up like she's going to the North Pole.
She has the pleasure of being for both games.
She's going to be here for 3 hours, that's all. So lucky Mary. She's going to be not so Mary DeRoss in about 5 minutes. Yeah, speaking of that one, going back to the A team, how about the DeRoss losing Colin DeRoss? He was a superstar. What a year he was having, too. And
leads team in sacks. He's thrown for two successful completions. Conversion.
I tell you, that's a kid who will be a huge loss for that A team, and he's got a cracked bone in his leg. But here we are here. It's going to be Harrigan under center with Sagala behind him. Look for see if Matt can get the ball. The keeper for Harrigan behind Sagala and Barboza. What a block by Barboza.
Finds the outside.
Gets wrapped up after a gain of about 6 or 7. And I literally right now my legs are shaking.
The operative phrase for the A team is next man up.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. They're getting low. They get a low count too as well on the how many players are getting out? About 17
today.
Oof.
Two go out, they forfeit. Yeah.
I know, that's how it works, so. Coming back here late in the game with this one well in hand for the Rockets. I'll talk a little bit about next week. It looks like we're going to Acton Boxborough, a team that before this day was 4-1 as well. So the Rockets, I had this one in hand from the start. Looked good. They did lose the ball once, Fleming, but I'll tell you, they've lost the ball quite a bit. So they've obviously talked about that in practice, that you got to control the ball. And who do you have there? It looks like Derek Van Horn back deep. It's going to be a pitch to Derek. Derek, it's a straight arm. Oh, he just gets pulled down by outside. So good play by number 70 there, but nice to see Derek get the ball. It was a good pitch to him, and he almost got outside, made something out of it.
He had room to run if he got past number 70. So what's the Rockets' record if they win today?
The Rockets will be 5-1 after today. They lost a very, very tight game with a good Draker team. They were very well matched. That was a game we lost 3 fumbles, too. So that's a team that we know we're already in the playoffs right now. We'd love to see that Draker team again.
Yeah.
That was a great game, though. A couple of good teams. Wakefield was very good this year, too. Number 53, Stevie Needham. Look at him. Looks like he's been running his whole life. Nice job.
First hit.
Spins around. He takes it for about 5 or 6. So, like to see it here with Coach getting some guys running the ball. It's nice. We look like they say fourth down. It could very well be that, as we're not paying attention, talking to each other late in the game. Yeah.
There's the Harrigan run and the.
That's a pitch right there. Look at that. Is that Zach Kenyon? He runs it for the first down. Oh, he's still on his feet. Oh, he doesn't want to go down. Woo! What a run by Kenyon.
Dragging Cowboys right up the middle.
Nice job. He wanted first down. He got more. And I tell you, it's tough to tackle out here when it's cold, man. It hurts a little bit more. We were talking about it. It looked like we have a player down on the field, so we're going to take a timeout. All right, and that's the end of the game here as they tend to it. They run the clock out in a powerful performance by the B team here today. It was set early with a steady dose of Lucas Fleming. He ran for 3 touchdowns today, including a 60-yarder on the very first play from scrimmage.
Wow.
A lot of great plays out here. Danny DeMari, number 22, had a great game. And the Rockets are going to move on to Acton Boxborough next week. Happy to see their player number 90 up. So the Rockets are giving their hands as they go through here. I'm going to pass it off to you guys. I wish I could go get you guys an extra jacket in my car, but I don't have one. So, hey, good luck to the A squad coming up, and we'll see you next week in Acton Boxborough.